How is everyone doing today? It is March 6th of 2022, and we finally got our first tomato tray planted up to get our tomatoes for the year in the yard started. Angel planted eight different varieties. I planted eight different varieties. We used an 18-cell tray. We keep the middle ones out so we can let some excess moisture vent off, and also to be able to check water, to be able to pull water from it if we have too much water in it, or able to water into it easily without moving it around too much. But I did eight varieties that are pretty much a theme of ours this year is I've went extremely unique, and Angel went extremely to the tried and true side. So I'll start with the types that Angel chose, the eight types she chose. She chose the black cherry, the black brandywine, Wagner Blue Green, Ava Purple Ball, Cherokee Purple, Black Crème, Japanese Black Trifle, and Hawaiian Pineapple. So these are eight types that we have grown in the yard, usually multiple years. The Wagner Blue Green we didn't grow last year, but several of these we even grew last year. The Cherokee Purple is always our favorite. One of my goals of the yard, in the center of the yard, is I want to plant the Cherokee Purple, the Black Crème, and the Carbon. Come to find out, I never ordered any Carbon seeds. Most places were out, so Carbon seeds are a little bit hard to come by. But I thought that we had some left over saved up, and we never did. So we have the Cherokee Purple to go in the center and the Black Crème. We're trying to source some Carbon seeds really quick. If we're unable to do so, the black brandywine is the one that's the stand-in. So it'll be the black brandywine, the black cream, and the Cherokee purple for the king tomato of the yard in the center of the yard, those three right there, unless we get the carbon, and then that one will hurry and jump forward. We'll multiple plant some of these. A couple of these varieties won't make it into our yard. We also want to plant five to seven dwarf varieties along with these 16 varieties here. So my type were the garden peach, indigo rose, Anana's Nore, Sartre Alois, White Wonder, Black Prince, Cherokee Green, and Accordion Orange. The garden peach we have grown before only one other time, and it was a pretty decent tomato, but we've grown it a couple times, but we didn't keep it in our yard. It's only made the yard one year. The White Wonder's one that we've grown, and we've had some of that before. It's a really excellent tomato, but only one time and not a great grow. So even though a couple of these we have grown before, but like the Cherokee Green as well, we've only grown one time. It wasn't last year, and it wasn't the best grow that we could have. Otherwise, the Black Prince, Accordion Orange, Sartre Alois, that looks like a really cool tomato. This one's catching a lot of buzz lately. A really nice looking tomato. But these are all from indeterminate types. Most of them are heirlooms, the vast majority of them. There might be one or two types in here that aren't necessarily heirlooms, but they are seeds from established varieties. That means that when I save seeds on these types right here, when we replant them next year, they won't be coming out as something different. They will most likely be true to type. And we do get a lot of crosses in our yards and stuff, but that's kind of the way to tell. A lot of the ones on the tried and true, some of them we were like the Cherokee Purple and Black Crème, we were shooting straight for the seeds, but like the Black Cherry, the Black Brandywine, and a couple others were from our save seeds, specifically kind of from last year, right?
Yeah, I think it was the year before, but it could have been
Maybe
last
the
year.
year before. Yeah, we didn't do too good on the Cherokee Purple last year. But anyways, Angel went with tried and true that have been grown several times in our yard. A lot of these even last year, and I went with pretty unique that might have hit the yard one time, but it's been a couple years ago, and we really want to see them again. So going unique and going tried and true. This is our first tomato tray. It is March 6th of 2022. And I will try to put the names of all of our choices down in the description. Our goal with our yard is to just keep on planting as many unique varieties as we can get our hands on, especially tomatoes and peppers. And then it's kind of like a Thunderdome process. Some of these varieties won't make it into the yard. Some of them might have different struggles for different reasons. But we just like to continue to plant as many unique varieties as we can. A lot of what compels us out in the yard is to see something really, really cool. So we've already got some water on these. It was pre-moistened soil made with coconut coir and perlite. It's an 18-cell tray with the two middle parts out. Let me give this to Angel real quick. Like I was saying, I'll try to put the links in the description, or not in the links, but the names of all the types that we chose down to the description. Get the humidity dome on it. This is a really tough process. You want to make 100% sure you don't put your stuff at risk. So we have it right here on a heat mat. We'll check the dome. If there's moisture in the morning and night, but not in the afternoon, it's about perfect. That's what you're looking for. If there's moisture in the afternoon, it has too much moisture, and you want to open the top up and let it vent off a little bit. And if there is no moisture in the morning and at night, then it's too dry, and you want to make sure you get some moisture in there and stuff like that. It pretty much has been the same from every altitude. These are our first 16 types of tomatoes. We have a grow light right up here. And I will go ahead and post the names of all of them in the description. Super, super excited. We moved some peppers for friends up to the very, very top without a heat mat. And we still got our first pepper tray right here starting to get sprouts on it. So once again, March 6th of 2022. And super, super fired up and ready to grow. Love you guys. Thanks for watching.